All right, thank you so much, Alexis. The 2024 Set and Demai Festival kicks off this weekend, and some of the folks involved are here with us today. Thank you so much for joining us. Mm-hmm. And we're going to talk a little bit about that. So good morning. How are you guys?
Good morning.
Great. And then let's start off with, why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about what this festival is about?
Your turn.
So this festival is celebrating the Constitution of Norway, and it's whatever weekend is closest to the 17th of May, because that is the day. So it will be this coming up weekend. Actually, Friday falls on the 17th.
And you do that every year, right?
That
is the significance
year, yeah.
of this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
It's May 17th, like you said.
Yep.
And this is a free event, correct?
The only thing that is cost is that you can buy a booster button. You can buy them throughout the festival at all the different locations. And this is, you buy it once, and then it gets you into any of the events.
All right. And so there's royalty in the building here today. Could you tell me a little bit about that process, and maybe tell, you know, the viewers a little bit about your titles as well?
The process was is that we were nominated, my wife Erin and I, Joe, were nominated to be King and Queen. And that we actually got to know that we were chosen in September. And so we had to keep this quiet until February, when we actually had the Norse Afternoon of Fun. And then it was known to everybody that we were the King and Queen. So we had to keep our mouths shut for a good part of the year.
A hard secret to keep, I'm sure.
Yeah, because we have five kids, and you know, four of them still at home. So yeah, it was really hard to keep it quiet.
And bragging rights, am I right? You know? So what can people expect to see this weekend at the festival?
We're looking forward to the parade, all the food tents. There's a lot of local clubs that are going to be selling all kinds of fun food down there. So we're going to take a walk downtown and see all our friends and neighbors and eat some good food.
And could you tell me a little bit about the Norwegian roots and history in Stoughton and in the Stoughton area?
So most of, a lot of Norwegians came and settled in Stoughton. And so when they came over, their traditions and celebrations came with them. So it was unofficially always celebrated the 17th of May. Then it became a national, or the citywide started celebrating in the 50s, and then the Stoughton Chamber of Commerce took it over in the 60s. So we've been going strong ever since.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And what are you guys looking forward to most, personally?
Oh, gosh. I mean, honestly, visiting the schools, because we do visit the grade schools, and just seeing the little kids look at the, not me, but look at the queen, and then look at the jewelry. The bunad is the official dress. That's what we're wearing. And just watching the little kids interact with the queen. It's really neat watching that.
Absolutely. And they also get to learn a little bit about the Norwegian culture as mm-hmm. well.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So thank you so much for being here with us today.
You
know, tonight at 27 News at 4, we will have the Norwegian dancers in studio for a special performance. Thank you so much.
Perfect.